Deep. Ready? Deep Purple, one of the original heavy metal bands, has decided to reunite after 8 years for an album and a tour. To reintroduce themselves to the music industry, they held this press conference in New York City.
We're back live with Ian Paice, Ian Gillan, Roger Glover, and John Lord of Deep Purple. We're sorry to say that the fifth member of the band, Ritchie Blackmore, was unable to join us today. Members of the press are ready with their questions for the group, so let's get started.
Gromhan from the German radio station SWF3. What was the main reason for the reunion of this band, since everybody was working on more or less successful solo projects?
after me.
Okay, after you, Roger.
There was a kind of sense of unfinished business after 1973. And there's been a lot of talk about us getting back together, which really didn't emanate from us, emanated from other people.
From whom?
And from businessmen, agents, managers, various entrepreneurs, record companies. I think because they had a situation where the band that didn't exist together was very popular, and for some reason selling records. We're all in the music business and we're all active in it, and all they had to do was get us to come together and tread the same boards on the same stage, and they'd see a lot of money in it. And that really wasn't our idea. We wanted to do it for the fact that it came from us for the first time in 11 years. We actually got together and said, why don't we do it? And so we did.
Great. Since Deep Purple disbanded, the hard rock music scene made a huge step forward. What did Deep Purple do to meet modern sound requirements?
A huge step backward, did you say?
Forward.
Oh, sorry. That's a matter of opinion.
Well, I think it made a huge step forward.
Should we fight?
No. Maybe afterwards.
Fine.
Don't you want
But he
to
has
answer?
To warn you, he's a karate expert. So I think that there have been no compromises made as far as we're concerned. When I heard the album for the first time, it was, to me, obviously Deep Purple. The sound was obviously Deep Purple. And John's still playing his Hammond organ and playing the piano and using some contemporary effects, but they're not dominant by any means. I think what was said earlier, the fact that we've all been involved in music over the last 10, 11 years since we broke up, we've absorbed whatever's been going on from our fellow musicians and what's going on in the world around us. And we're all sort of match fit in musical terms. That's, I think, the only answer. We don't consciously go in and look at the production angle of an album when we go in to do it. It's just there or it's not. And the chemistry of the band is, I think, all that's needed as far as we're concerned. The production angles Roger looks at afterwards in terms of sound and everything else. Obviously, there's a great advancement in terms of studio techniques and everything else. But we recorded this album on a mobile in a basement in Vermont. And when we'd finished there, we went to Germany, to Hamburg, to use some of the finest studios available. To get the little bits you need on top, which Roger knows about. I call them little bits on top. He's got proper names for them.
Hi guys, I'm Colonel St. James from 97 Rock in Houston, and my question is: can you give us some idea about when Perfect Stranger will be released, and what can we expect as far as musical direction, if there is one, on the album?
I don't know.
It's coming out beginning of November, right? About a week.
Yep.
Something like that.
Well, okay. Comes in about a week.
That's called yeah. Perfect Strangers.
Perfect Strangers.
Yeah, it's
okay.
Called Perfect Stranger.
It's, in a way, it's immediately recognizable. You're talking about musical direction.
Right.
It's immediately recognizable, I think, as Deep Purple from the moment you put the needle in the groove. However, it is not 1974. It's 1984. So this goes back some way to the last question. We have made not so much a conscious effort, but just because of the fact that we are still here. The feeling of the band is still as
vibrant.
It was before, of attempts at innovation within what we believe in. And if that's an answer to your question, then I'm a Chinaman.
Well, thanks very much. Look forward to seeing y'all in Houston.
Thank you very much indeed. Cheers.
Hi everyone, I'm Tommy Hadges from KLOS in Los Angeles. It's great to see you all back together again.
And thank you.
I remember In the old days, Deep Purple spent a lot of time on the road. I wonder if you could share with us your touring plans for the coming year.
Actually, a lot of time on the road.
We spent a little too much time on the road before.
Are you going to do the same thing this time around?
Exactly.
Yeah.
If a thing's worth doing, it's worth overdoing, I believe.
And there's a common misconception that human beings actually learn from their mistakes, I think.
Okay, so any specifics?
Actually, you got a list somewhere, haven't you?
Yeah, it's in my head, but I left that behind. We're starting in Australia in about 3 or 4 weeks' time, which is going to take us up till Christmas, Australia, New Zealand. Then mid-January, we start in the States for around 12 weeks, a couple of weeks off, and then we go to Japan for a few shows, and then a couple of weeks off, and we go into Europe, starting in the south. You'll notice by the dates that we're following the sun, actually. We're kicking out of the...
Except for America.
Oh, we're doing the southern and western, aren't we?
So that we can fly through blizzards.
Yeah. And then into Europe, starting in the south, going north, finishing in the UK. Another short break, and then we'll be back into the US for open air shows in the summer. And then we might take a weekend off or something.
I look forward to seeing you in Southern California.
Thank you very much. I
look forward to seeing you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Martha Quinn.
You certainly are.
Hi, Martha.
Hi, Martha.
How you doing? Since 1976, when Deep Purple left the scene, heavy metal has had a big resurgence. Is that partly why you got back together?
Actually, we're not a heavy metal band. We're more sort of country and western compared to heavy metal. Actually, no, I don't know why we got back together. I don't think it was for any overt musical reason. It was the musical reason came from within us. Whatever we did, I think none of us actually knew what chemistry was that provided us with the music and the success that we had. And having got back together again, a lot of people have said, what is it that makes you tick? And we actually don't know. There's something about the five of us when we work together.
What is it that makes us that thick?
Thick. No, you're thick.
Don't.
There's a certain chemistry about it that you can't put into words. I don't think it's got anything to do with what's happening currently with any so-called heavy metal revival. Any heavy metal revival that I've heard has been going on for about the last 10 years anyway. There's always a revival going on. And I don't think we paid any attention to current things any more now than we did before.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, so nice to see you together again. I'm Ted Edwards from KGBFM in San Diego, California. I was wondering, lighting and special effects have come a long way since the early days of Deep Purple. In fact, stage lighting has made great strides since that time. And if you look, in fact, on the Made in Japan cover, you'll show how simple it was then. So what can we expect from Deep Purple stage-wise over the next year?
We're
going to
use one on both sides of the stage now. we have to acknowledge that things have changed. But we've all, as Roger said, we've all been working all the way through this period between the first Purple and what we are now. And we're used to the fact that we have to use good lights and we have to use good PA and we have to use them to the best advantage. So hopefully we'll be able to take this opportunity to use good lights to their best effect and good PA to its best effect.
You're talking Thanks about an 8-truck tour instead of a 2-truck tour, really, basically,
yeah.
as it used
yeah.
to be.
I think also the thing with any stage that we might construct to take with us, it would have to be a stage that was in itself meaningless until we got on it. We won't be taking replicas of castles around with us and pyramids, and there's no knights in shining armor bit about this band, that which is a sort of current obsession with quote-unquote heavy metal bands.
What about Stonehenge?
I've got an option on Stonehenge, too.
There's a spare Stonehenge set lying around in England.
Thanks very much. We'll see you in San
Thank
Diego.
You.
Thank
Cheers.
You.
Good afternoon. I'm Rad Messick from WDIZ in Orlando. And over the past few years, I guess, it's been pretty well publicized. You guys have had some personality problems or some inner conflicts. How's that situation nowadays? And I guess maybe even more obvious than that, where's Ritchie?
Well, Ritchie's fixing his cat today. He couldn't make it. No, as Sister Matilda says, Ritchie, don't do this sort of thing. We've all still got our own personality problems, but I think the only problem that happened at the end of 72 and into 73, when this particular lineup split, was that we were basically knackered. exhausted, and there was very little experience from management and things like that in those days in terms of how to deal with people, how to say, okay, stop, just take 3 months off, take 6 months off, get away from each other, you come back fresh and all that sort of thing. I think the one thing we have learned is to be able to recognize those symptoms when they arise now and hopefully cater for them. We're not looking on this as a one-off, one album, one tour reunion. This is permanent.
We've been talking
permanent as it can be in a rock and roll lifetime.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
We've been talking a lot about the new album, and I think everybody's anxious to hear a little bit of it, so we're going to play the title song. Here's new Deep Purple, Perfect Strangers.
Oh, they got it on here.
Dance. Close, very close.
We're going to take a question or two after the song.
Right.
We're going to go a little bit longer.
Sure.
We are going to take a question.